Lubin's novel may have been that his hand was two sizes too small. But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve hating the Who's, staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown. But the warm lighted windows glow in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now, hanging a mistletoe wreath. And they're hanging their stockings, his narrow was near. Tomorrow is Christmas, it's practically here. Then he ground with his green fingers nervously drumming. I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming. For tomorrow, he knew all the cool girls and boys wait break and early. They'd wash for their toes. And all the noise, noise. That's one thing he hated. The noise, noise. Then the Who's, young and old, would sit down to the feast. And they'd feast, and they'd feast, feast. And the murderer, they would feast on her pudding and rare her roast beast. Which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. And they'd feast, and they'd feast, and they'd feast, feast. And they'd feast on her pudding and rare her roast beast. Which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. Then they'd do something he liked least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing, would then stand hand in hand, and they'd Who's would start singing. And they'd sing, and they'd sing, and it'd sing, sing. And the more the Grinch thought, his Who Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought,